स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्तां वो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नकाः. सो द लास्ट् श्लोकं वि सॉ वास् यथार् पदार्थद्वारेण वाक्यार्थसम्प्रतीयते वाक्यार्थ वाच्यार्थपूर्विका तद्वत् प्रतिपत्तस्य वस्तुनः तस्य वस्तुनः वि टाकिङ्ग् अबौट् द प्रतीयमानार्थं विच् is understood vachyarthapurvika eva, just like how we need the meaning of words to understand the meaning of a sentence. After the sentence meaning is understood, we are still not going to dwell on the word meaning. Padartha dvarena eva vakyarthaha pratiyate, but we are not focusing on the padartha. Correct? That is your drishtantam, example. So in the same way, for a sahrudaya also, vachyartha purvika tadvati, in the same way, vachyartha purvika eva tasya vastunaha vyangyarthasya pratipati jnanam jayate. And after that, we are not going to keep dwelling on the words so much. So once we understand the rasam and we start enjoying that vyangyartha, we will only keep looking at that vingyartha. We will probably understand that it is only through the words that we understand. Brahma, Dharmika, Vishrabda and all we understand. But once you get to the vingyartham, then the vingyartham shines forth more beautifully than the vachyartha. Even though the vachyartha helps you in understanding the vingyartham. Now, this vingyartha, why he starts off is idanim vachyartha pratiti purvakatve api. Okay, I understand that vachyartha, we understand, but why do you have to explain when you are trying to explain dvani? What is the use of vachya and vyangya? What is the relationship between dvani and this vachya vyangya that you are talking about? So idanim vachyartha pratiti purvikatve api. वाच्यार्थ प्रतीति पूर्विकत्वे अपि तत्प्रतीतेः व्यंग्यस्य अर्थस्य प्राधान्यं यथा न व्यालुप्यते तथा दर्शयति. इन् दिस् काण्टेक्स्ट् प्रकृते, इन् दिस् काण्टेक्स्ट् वाट् हि इस् ट्रैङ्ग् टु एक्स्प्लेन् इस् वाच्यार्थ पूर्विकत्वे वाच्यार्थ प्रतीति पूर्वकत्वे अपि, ईवन् दो व्यङ्ग्यार्थ इस् ओन्लि थ्रू द वाच्यार्थं, दट् व्यङ्ग्यार्थम् इस् इम्पार्टेण्ट्. तत् प्रतीतेः व्यङ्ग्यार्थस्य प्रतीतेः व्यङ्ग्यार्थस्य व्यङ्ग्यस्य अर्थस्य एव प्राधान्यं यथा न व्यालुप्यते. हि इस् ट्रैङ्ग् टु एक्स्प्लेन् तथा दर्शयति. हि शोयिङ्ग् इन् सच् अ मेनर् देट् दिस् दिस् द इम्पार्टेन्स् आफ् व्यङ्ग्यार्थ इस् नाट् डिमिनिश्ड्. सो यु आर् नाट् अण्डर्मैनिङ्ग् द वेल्यू आफ् व्यङ्ग्यार्थ, ईवन् दो वेन् यु से देट् इट् इस् ओन्लि थ्रू द वाच्यार्थ देट् ऐ अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् द व्यङ्ग्यार्थ. स्वसामर्थ्यवशेनैव वाक्यार्थं प्रतिपादयन् यथा व्यापारनिष्पत्तौ पदार्थः न विभाव्यते. सो वाट् ऐ सेड् वेन् एक्स्प्लेनिङ्ग् द अर्लियर् श्लोक कारिका, स्वसामर्थ्यवशेन पदार्थः स्वसामर्थ्यं, स्वसामर्थ्यं मीन्स् फार् अ पदार्थं वि नीड् आकाङ्क्षा योग्यता एण्ड् सन्निधि. आकाङ्क्षा अस्मात् पदात् अयमर्थः बोद्धव्यः. नो नो सारी, आकाङ्क्षा इस् वन् वर्ड् एक्स्पेक्ट्स् अनदर् वर्ड् फार् द अर्थपूर्ति फार् अण्डर्स्टाण्डिङ्ग् द एण्टैर् मीनिङ्ग्. ऐ केनाट् जस्ट् से पुरुषः हस्ति अश्वः पात्रं पुस्तकं घटः फुल् स्टाप्. दिस् केनाट् बी अ सेण्टेन्स् because one does not, what there should be an expectancy for one word for another. If I say gachati, then I can say ramaha gachati, and or I should say ramaha gajah ashvaha purushah gachanti, then I can say the sentence is more meaningful. Each word expects the other for completing its sense. It is not an enumeration, it is not a listing. So that is akanksha. Yogyata, for this word, this is the meaning that should be, it should be connected with. There should be a compatibility between the meaning. I cannot say pustakam khadami, I am not a donkey. A man cannot say that. So there is no yogyata in that. The example you have in Shastram is Agnina Sinchati. You cannot sprinkle, you can only jale naiva sinchana karyasya yuktatvat yogyata vartate jale eva sinchana kriyayaha. Kintu sinchana kriyayaha agnau yogyata na vartate. You cannot sprinkle with fire. You have to only sprinkle with water. So agnina sinchati iti vakye yogyata virahaha vartate. Next is sannidhi. I cannot say pustakam today and say tomorrow anaya. You will ask me, what is this pustakam? Why are you suddenly blabbering? You are just saying random words. And then you are saying anaya, what should I bring? That it will never be satisfied if the words are not together, said in proximity. So proximity is also important. All these three are responsible for the capability of a word to give the sentence meaning. So padarthasya swasamarthya vashenaiva padarthaha vakyartham prakashayati. Vakyartham katam prakashayati swasamarthya vashat. Swasamarthya means by its own capability. It has that capability. No, it doesn't have that capability of conveying a sentence meaning. Padartham has the capability of conveying only the meaning of that particular word. If it has to help in conveying the meaning of a sentence, it needs something called samarthyam. What is that samarthyam? These are the three things that contribute towards the samarthyam of a padartha. Akanksha, expectancy, yogyata, compatibility, sannidhi is proximity. Huh? So, yatha, swasamarthya vashena iva vakyartham prakashayan, pratipadayan, as it is showing the meaning of the sentence, padarthaha, what does it do? Vyapara nishpattau. After it has given reason, after the sentence meaning has arisen in our mind, the work of the padartha is done. Vyapara nishpattau. Na vibhaktataya na vibhavyate means vibhavyate vipurvaka, vi upasarga purvaka bhavadatu. So here what you do is vibhavyate for vi, not visheshena bhavyate, atava vibhaktataya na bhavyate. So na vibhavyate, na vibhaktataya bhavyate. Separately, you cannot, so grihatu pustakam anaya. Grihat, panchami vibhakti is there after griha, so it means from the house. And grihat what? Pustakam anaya. So each word meaning we have got from the house. Book, bring. You have that. Oh, so bring the book from the house. After that, grihat is not going to be in your mind separately. You will never think of that word separately in your mind. Hmm? Tadvat sachetasam so artaha vachyarthamimukatmanam buddhau tattvartha dashinyam jatityeva avabhasate. These two are connected. Swasamarthya vashenaiva vakyartham pratipadayan yatha vyapara nishpatto padartho na vibhavyate tadvat sachetasam so artho vachyarthamimukhanam buddhau tattvartha dashinyam jatityeva avabhasate. These two are connected together. So tadvat, in the same manner. Now what is happening here? Saha arthaha, vyangyarthaha, vachyartha vimukhatmanam sachetasam buddhau, tatvartha darshinyam buddhau. So for sachetasa is sahrdaya. Sahrdayanam buddhau, sahrdayanam manasi, buddhitatve, saha arthaha, vyangyarthaha, jhatityeva avabhasate. Immediately it appears in the minds of the Sahridaya. Who is this Sahridaya? Vachyartha Vimukhanam. Vachyartha Eva, they do not focus their attention on the Vachyartha. They are completely phased away from the Vachyartha. Vachyartha Parangmukhatmanam. Sachetasam Sahridayanam Manasi Buddhau. How is that Buddhi? Tattvartha Darshini. Tattvam is subtle things. They are able to अण्डर्स्टेण्ड् द सटलिटीस् आफ् अ काव्यं, काव्यतत्त्वस्य अर्थं ये पश्यन्ति ते, काव्य द बुद्धि, द मैण्ड्, इण्टलेक्ट् आफ् द सहृदय इस् केपबल् आफ् अण्डर्स्टेण्डिङ्ग् काव्यतत्त्वं. सो सूक्ष्मार्थं काव्येषु सूक्ष्म अर्थान् ज्ञातुं शक्नुवन्ति. सो बुद्धौ तत्त्वार्थदर्शिन्यां बुद्धौ सः अर्थः व्यङ्ग्यार्थः झटिति एव इमीडियट्लि अवभासते, इट् स्फुरति. नौ सो नौ इस् वेर् वेन् ऐ सेड् यु नो यु हव् एक्स्प्लेन्ड् अबौट् व्यङ्ग्यार्थस्य प्राधान्यं, वाट् इस् इट्स् कनेक्षन् वित् ध्वनि. काव्यस्यात्मा ध्वनिरित बुधैः यस्समाम्नातपूर्वः नास्ति एव तस्य अभावं जगदुः and all that. So now you were only talking about vachya and pratiyamanartha. How pratiyamanartha is different from vachyartha. Kvachit vidhi roope pratiyamanarthasya pratishedha roopaha. Kvachit pratishedha vachya sati. You have given all sorts of examples for all vachyartham and pratiyamanartham. You have spoken about vyangyartha, how that vyangyartha is important. Now, where are you going to connect it to the context? Now he starts off with dhaniswarupam. एवं वाच्यव्यतिरेकिणः व्यङ्ग्यार्थस्य सद्भावं प्रतिपाद्य अस्ति एव ध्वनिः इति प्रतिपाद्य तत्तु वाच्यात् व्यतिरिक्तः भवति. इट् इस् डिफरेण्ट् फ्रम् द प्रैमरी मीनिङ्ग्. अ व्यङ्ग्यार्थ इस् प्रेसेण्ट् एण्ड् आफ्टर् शोयिङ्ग् द प्रेसेन्स् आफ् सच् अ व्यङ्ग्यार्थ प्रकृते उपयोजयन्, प्रकृते इत्युक्ते काण्टेक्स्ट्, द यूस्फुल्नेस् आफ् the above discussion in the context, upayojayan, he is showing the usefulness of it. Etrartha shabdova tamartham upasarjani krita swartho vyangtak kavya vishesha sadvaniriti suribhik kritah. Yatra yasmin kavye, in a kavyam where you have a shabda and an artha, where they have completely submerged themselves or made themselves as unimportant. Upasarjani krita swarthau swasya artha, artha prayojanam. It is not artha means meaning in that. Artha is prayojanam. Atma swasya atma atmanaha prayojanam. So upasarjani kritam, upasarjani apradhani kritam. Apradhana akritau I have written. Please don't look at the slide. I've made a spelling mistake there. It is actually apradhani kritau atma prayojanam yabhyam tau artaha shabdaha cha. So yatra yasmin kavye, in whichever kavyam that you are reading, there is a shabdam and artham, which is shabdaha is the primary shabda, which is the vachaka shabdaha. Arthaha is your vachyarthaha. Ubhav api, what happens to them, this or that? Upavapi means both of them should not have any importance in the kavya. So upasarjani krita swarthau, they have completely, their the prayojanam has, they've made themselves unimportant. And then kavya visheshaha vyanktaha, vyanktaha vyanakti vyanktaha, it is a latlakaram of vyanj dhatu. So vyanktaha is in dual. So artha shabdaha cha yatra vyanktaha tam artham vyanktaha, wherever the shabda vyachyartha and the vachaka shabda are vyanktaha vyanjana vyaparena prakashayataha, where they are showing or suggesting through vyanjana vyapara vyangyartham tam artham is actually very important. I have to take pratiyamanam punar anyadeva vastvasti vanishu mahakavinam. All of those three shlokas that you saw, Saraswati, Sadhu, Swadhu, all those three shlokas which were explaining how the pratiyamanartha is the most beautiful, that artham, you have to take it here. The tam discusses the artha which gives anandam to the sahridaya. So tam artham, see, in Lochanam, he says Saraswati, Sadhu, Tadartha, Vastu, iti yaduktam tam artham. Vyantaha, Dyotayataha. सहा एव काव्यविशेषः ध्वनिः इति सूरिभिः कथितः. ओन्ली दट् काव्यम् इस् काल्ड् ध्वनि. नौ वि सो हि हेस् एक्स्प्लेन्ड् द स्वरूपम् आफ् ध्वनि. right? So shabda and artha contribute equally. Otherwise, so why does he include both the vachyartha? Till now he was only saying vachya, he was saying vachya vachyartha purvika eva. Vachyartha purvika means only the vachyartha is a contributor for artha. You have to say that the vachyartham is also a contributor, or shabdam can also be a contributor, because you can have the shabda shakti muladvani also. So shabda is also a contributor. Only a known shabda is a contributor. You can't have a unknown. That's why it is one goes with the other. Both the artham and the shabdam coexist together and are suggesting the pingartha. That's why you can't just have the shabdam or the artham. Now, abhavavadi, we saw three pakshas there. One is koyam dhvanihi, next is nasti eva dhvanihi, and then ukta charutva hetushu antarbhavaha. Now he is going to address each and every of those misconceptions. Till now, he just said kavyasya atma dhvanihi, sayeva uktaha, and that can be explained, and I am going to explain and give the definition of it. Everything is fine. Now, it is completely different from vachyartha. Why does he give such a big prelude or a bhumika? He is going to remove the misconceptions that are there about dhvani. Now, he starts off with replying to the purvapaksha. So, what was the first abhavavadi's paksham? Koyam dhvanihi, what is this dhvani? Anena vachya vachaka charutva hetubhyaha upamadibhyaha anuprasadibhyaha vibhakta eva dhvanehe vishayaha iti darshitam. It is completely different from vachya vachaka charutva hetuhu. So what is dhvani? It is different from what you know. That is the answer, first one. So koyam dhvanir nama iti abhavavadinam uttaram atra. It is different from whatever you know hitherto, whatever you have understood till now. What have you understood till now? Vachya vachaka charutva hetu. Vachya is vachyartham, primary meaning. Vachaka, primary word. Tesham vachyanam vachakanam cha charutva hetavaha santi iti tvaya purvam viditam eva. Kete upamadibhyaha vachyarthanam charutva hetavaha. Upamadi arthalankaraha. Next is vachaka shabdanam charutva hetavaha shabdalankaraha anuprasadayaha. So anuprasadibhyaha upamadibhyaha panchami vibhakti tebhyaha vibhaktaha eva bhinnaha eva dvanehe vishayaha. So someone who is asking koyam dvanihi, he is asking what is this dvani? See, where is that first paragraph? 1 minute. Kechid achakshiran shabdartha shariram tavat kavyam. I think that's where we have to start. Right? The abhavavadin. Yeah, ama. So tatra kechid achakshiran shabdartha shariram tavat kavyam. Tatra shabdakataha charutva hetavaha anuprasadayaha. Arthakataha upamadayaha. Varna sangatana dharmaha madhuryadayaha. Tad anatirikta vrittayaha vrittayaha. Ritayaha tad vyatiriktaha koyam dvanihi. So, he enlisted the things that he knew and asked, what is this dhvani that you are talking about? So, the first thing, how do you answer such a person? Whatever you said, it is different from whatever you have said. So, that is all he addresses with them. So, anena, from the whole bhumika that he gave now, vachya vachakatva charu vachaka charutva hetubhyaha upamadibhyaha anuprasadibhyaha bhinnaha eva dvanehe vishayaha iti purvameva aduna darshitam bhumika rupena. Next, the second paragraph, anyebi bruyuhu. What did they say? Dvitiya pakshaha. I should have put tabs on this. Nasti eva dvanihi iti dvitiya pakshaha abhavavadinam. So nasti eva dvanihi prasiddha prasthana vyatirekinaha kavyatya hanihi eva sahridaya hridaya akhladi shabdarthamayatvam eva kavyalakshanam iti uktam. So how does he answer yadapyuktam? The first line is the purvapakshi's line. Prasiddha prasthana atirekinaha margasya, a path or a concept that is atireki atikraminaha, that surpasses the prasthana, the prasiddha prasthana, the popular path, the trodden path. You are trying to not go on a path which has already been gone by many people over the centuries. You are trying to adopt a new path. If it is beyond the prasiddha prasthana, then kavyahanehe, because it contributes to the deterioration of a kavyam, dvanihi nasti iti yadapi uktam. There is no dvani. That is what you said before. Tadapi ayuktam eva. That does not hold good. Why? Yataha. Because lakshanakritam eva sakevalam na prasiddaha lakshyetu parikshyamane saeva sakritaya akhladakari kavya tattvam. Tataha anyat chitram eva iti agre darshayishyamaha. It's not something that I am telling out of the blue. You know, I'm not taking something like a, you know, how people take out of a magician's hat. That is not what I'm doing. Lakshana kritam eva sakevalam na prasiddaha. It is, not only is it popular among people who are lakshanakrit, those who have written the definitions of kavyam or the concepts of, laid down the beautiful concepts of a kavyam. It is also prevalent among people. Sakhridaya hridaya akhladakari kavyatattvam sayeva iti lakshye parikshyamane sati jnayate. Lakshye kavye parikshyamane sati. It is in saptami. Sati saptami. So when you analyze a kavya, the lakshya, saha arthaha, saha dvanihi, sahridaya hridaya akhladakari kavyatattvam iti prasiddha, or it is nyayate. So we understand that the dvani is the one that contributes to the happiness of a sahridaya. Tataha anyat dvanehe anyat sarvam. Anything apart from dvani is only chitram. It is just a play of words and meaning. It's like a chitrakavyam. No, it is only a jalam that you show. Iti agre darshayishyamaha, we are going to, he is going to talk about it in second udyotam, even in first udyotam later, and all that. Now the third one, what was the third tritiyav pakshaha? Ukta charutva hetushu eva antarbhavaha. Punarapi punarapare tasya abhavam anyatha kathayeyuhu na sambhavatyeva dvanirnama apurvaha kachit kamaniyakam anativartamanasya tasya ukteshweva charutva hetushu antarbhavat tesham anyatamasyaiva va apurva samakhya matra karane yatkinchana kathanam syat. That was the earlier abhavavadi argument. So kamaniyakam anativartamanasya tasya tasya dvanehe, you're saying dvani contributes to the beauty of the poetry. So kamaniyakam, something which saundarya karakam iti anati vartamanasya tasya, it is not beyond something which contributes beauty to it. It also contributes beauty to a kavyam. See, that itself is it also contributes beauty. No, what we are trying to say, dvanikara is trying to say, is it is the only thing that is contributing to the beauty of the kavyam. So it's not one of the things that contributes. So tasya ukta alankaradi prakareshu eva antarbhavaha iti yadapi uktam abhavavadibihi tadapi asamichinam. That is also not correct, because vachya vachaka matra ashrayini prasthane. Vachya vachaka matra ashrayini, vachyam and vachakam. So, ukta alankaradi, whatever you have said, only depends on vakya and vachaka, correct? So, vachya and vachaka, which is vachyartha and vachaka shabda. So, which means shabda alankara and artha alankara. Tanmatra ashrayini prasthane. The margam that you are talking about only depends on the primary word and primary meaning. Vyengyavanjaka samashrayena vyavastitasya dhvanehe. The dvani that I am trying to establish, or I have established here, is dependent on vyengya and vyanjaka, or a suggested meaning and a suggested word. कथम अन्तर्भावः, हौ केन् यू इन्क्लूड् इट् अण्डर् अलङ्कारस्. वाच्यवाचक चारुत्वहेतवः हि तस्य अङ्गभूताः ध्वने, तस्य इत्युक्ते ध्वनेः अङ्गभूताः भवन्ति, बिकास् वाच्यार्थपूर्विका एव तम् अर्थम्. वि अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दट् व्यङ्ग्यार्थ ओन्लि थ्रू द वाच्यवाचक शब्द. सो इट् इस् एन् आक्चुलि एन् अङ्गम् आफ् द प्रधान ध्वनि. सो द ध्वनि केनाट् बि इन्क्लूडेड् इन् इट्स् अङ्गम्. स तु अङ्गिरूपः एव इति प्रतिपादयिष्यमाणत्वात् ऐ एम् गोयिङ्ग् टु टाक् अबौट् द ध्वनि एण्ड् एक्स्प्लेन् इट् एस् being the pradhana angi. So parikara shlokaha cha atra, the conclusive shlokam here is vyangya vyanjaka sambandha nibandhanataya dhvanehe vachyavachaka charutva hetu antapatita kutaha. How can sidhvani nibandhanataya, na dhvani is based upon the fact that it depends or it is connected with vyangya and vyanjaka. Vyangya vyanjaka sambandhenaiva dvanehe nibandhanam kriyate, nirmanam kriyate, athava tasya jnanam asti. Vachya vachaka charutva hetu antapatita kutaha. How can it be included under something which only beautifies the primary word and primary meaning? Okay.
The conclusion of some sort. என்னது?
Yes, parikarangarche idudan conclusion.
Okay.
So it is all the three abhavavadins can be combined into one concept of there is no dhvani. நீ எப்படி சொன்னாலுமே, எந்த விதத்துல சொன்னாலுமே, எந்த பிரக்ரியை யூஸ் பண்ணாலுமே, இட் இஸ் வாட் யூ ஆர் ட்ரைங் டு சே இஸ் dhvani does not exist. If it exists, it can probably only contribute to the degradation of a poetry, or you please include it under what exists. Adukku vandu oru conclusive statement madri solrar, I can never accept including dhvani under alankara or ukta charutva hetu. Not only alankara, alankara sangatana guna riti vritti, any of those things I cannot do it, because all of these things are based on vachya and vachaka, whereas dhvani is based on vyangya and vyanjaka. Seriya? So that is like a conclusive shlokam for adena nirakaranam pandrathukku inda idha. You are negating all the abhavavadins, removing the misconceptions that are based on based upon dhvani, about dhvani. Okay?